21 in the booklet.
And walk in your ways to the glory. reading from the book of Zephaniah. Be silent before the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. The Lord has prepared a sacrifice. He has consecrated his guests. At that time, I will search Jerusalem with lamps, and I will punish the people who rest complacently on their dregs, those who say in their hearts, the Lord will not do good, nor will he do harm. Their wealth shall be plundered, and their houses laid waste. Though they build houses, they shall not inhabit them. Though they plant vineyards, they shall not drink wine from them. The great day of the Lord is near, near and hastening fast. The sound of the day of the Lord is bitter. The warrior cries aloud there. That day will be a day of wrath, a day of distress and anguish, a day of ruin and devastation, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of trumpet blast and battle cry against the fortified cities and against the lofty battlements. I will bring such distress upon people that they shall walk like the blind. Because they have sinned against the Lord, their blood shall be poured out like dust and their flesh like dung. Neither their silver nor their gold will be able to save them on the day of the Lord's wrath. In the fire of his passion, the whole earth shall be consumed. For a full, a terrible end he will make of all the inhabitants of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. Now concerning the times and the seasons, brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anything written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. When they say there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them, as labor pains come upon a pregnant woman, and there will be no escape. But you, beloved, are not in darkness, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all children of light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. So then let us not fall asleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who are drunk, get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God has destined us not for wrath, but for obtaining salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live with him. Therefore, encourage one another and build up each other, as indeed you are doing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
of heaven will be as when a man, going on a journey, summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, "Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." And the one with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, "Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." Then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, "Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours." But his master replied, "You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was in my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Able, we will proceed with morning prayer with the Apostles' Creed found To him. In doing so, he buried his own future. His fear had overcome the hope in the future that motivated his companions. God entrusts to us a world which is rich beyond our knowing. And how do we respond? In our treatment of the natural resources of the planet, for example, are the risks we are taking motivated by a desire to enhance the long-range future of life as we know it, or our risks merely self-promoting? Jesus puts before us this paradoxical truth that if we are to gain, we must take risks. If we are to find our lives, we must lose them. And we are to do this not for our own sake, but for the sake of others who, like us, are children of God. The consequences of living out this truth is twofold. First, we shall be rewarded with even greater responsibility. And second, we are offered joy as a reward for living in the truth. We cannot take lightly the judgment of God which falls upon the third servant. The description of consequences should be enough to motivate even the most fearful among us to become risk takers. Having endowed each of us with unique gifts, God expects us to do something with them. If we don't, we shall be called to account. But let us also hear Paul's assurance that we are all sons and daughters of the light, and let us don the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. Placing our security in these gifts, we can follow our unique call to lead lives of risky discipleship. Then we shall not be dominated by fear, but by the joy of a life well lived in truth. And I have some brief comments on that meditation. When the author speaks about risk-taking, I think of this parish right now in the midst of a transition. And there are many opportunities for people in the parish to maybe step out of what is comfortable for you and what you offer to the parish and take on something that might be a little risk-taking. So go back to the parable as it is written in the Gospel of Matthew. Those three people, the three slaves, received talents. Talents in that reading were money. They were coins. They were pieces of money. But when I hear the word talent, I also think of gifts. What gifts do I have? What gifts do each of you have? And what gifts do you have that maybe you can step out of that safety zone and offer them to us? So I can give you just a brief example in my life. When I knew and sensed a call to become a deacon, I kept it a secret in my heart for several years because I didn't want to risk what I would have to face if I actually entered the deacon formation program. I did. I stepped out of my safety zone. I spoke with the rector in the parish where I was serving, and then began the process of filling out forms and interviews and so on and so forth. The reason I didn't want to say anything about my call was because I said, I don't know how to chant, I can't sing, how can I preach? So one of the greatest gifts that came to me in the Deacon Formation Program was two professors. The professor that taught our class how to chant and the professor who taught us preaching. The professor who taught us chanting said, anybody who can talk can sing and can chant. Now, obviously, there are levels of quality. Early on, chanting wasn't so good for me, but I think it got better over 23 years. But the point is that what I was afraid of, God took care of and had professors that actually gave me the confidence that I needed to go forth with the program. So I look out here and every Sunday you see people who come up here and read. Maybe somebody out here or even listening online, maybe, you know, you would like to risk becoming a lector or a server at the altar or an acolyte. And the big risk might be, yes, being willing to serve on the vestry. You know, you hear serving on the vestry and everybody kind of freezes up, but it's a wonderful ministry. It's the leadership of a parish. So I end this meditation with a comment about this week. We will celebrate Thanksgiving, and it's a time when we're with family, we eat good food, we have fellowship. But also this year, might you take some time to look into your own heart and soul, and what are the blessings you have received, maybe blessings you've received from this parish, and how are you maybe being called to step out of your safety zone and take some risks to volunteer to do something that you've never done here in the parish before. And if it involves being a lector or serving at the altar or being an acolyte, you would receive training and help in order to become involved in that ministry. So happy Thanksgiving. And remember on Thanksgiving Day all of the blessings that you have received and how you might bring some of those blessings here to the parish. Amen.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Because I'm already here, I usually do announcements here. And then everybody can hear them better. So in the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our primate, Sally, our diocesan bishop, William and Joe Morris, our retired bishops, our companion dioceses of Ecuador Central and Ecuador Litoral, for the province of Jerusalem and the Middle East, and for the clergy and people in the diocese on the Anglican cycle of prayer this week. In our diocese, we pray for Trinity Cathedral, for St. Elizabeth's Chapel by the Sea in Orkney Beach, and St. Elizabeth's Church in Elizabeth. We pray for the wardens, the members of the vestry, for parishioners and staff of Holy Apostles during this time of transition. In our world, we pray for our nation, for Joseph, for Kamala, for members of Congress and the judiciary, and for Philip, our governor. We pray for the leaders of all nations and those working for peace and nuclear disarmament, for people suffering from the effects of wars and other disasters, and all those working to meet the needs of the suffering, for the safety and well-being of all men and women serving in the armed forces and for their loved ones, for all refugees and immigrants and victims of trafficking, unemployment, and violence, especially gun violence, for an awareness of sustaining the environment, our society, and the economy, and for the outreach ministries of this parish. We pray for those celebrating birthdays, Christopher Naroda, Andrew Barlow, and Linda Wagner. We pray for those who are ill in body, mind, or spirit, for Liliana
infant and her mother, Stephanie, for Kelly, Betty Ann, Ernie S., Dennis, Nancy, Bill, Tony, Joe, Clayton, Lynn and Bob, Carol, Quincy, Alfred, Salvatore, Denny, Elise, Gil, and Crew, William, Dennis, and Debbie, Angeline, and Lynn. We pray for holy death and peace at the last for Robin, for those on the hearts and minds of our gleanings guests, for those who live with prolonged illnesses, those preparing for and recovering from surgery, those who are with child, and those who mourn and grieve. We pray for the departed, for Charles Gravener, whose funeral is tomorrow and he will be interred, for the Right Reverend David Bruce Jocelyn and Janet Dunn, the shrine candles burn to the glory of God and in loving memory of Lily Young.
Thank you.
The following, hymn 335, you will need your yellow piece of paper for communion from the reserve section.
Thank you.
comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst. Almighty Father, whose dear Son, on the night before he suffered, instituted the sacrament of his body and blood, mercifully grant that we may receive it thankfully in remembrance of Jesus Christ our Lord, who in these holy mysteries gives us a pledge of eternal life, and who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And let us pray in the words our Savior Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Gotcha.
Cathedral is always grateful for our continued support of their Thanksgiving outreach. So am I, grateful for your donations. So, Advent brunch.
Back by popular demand, we're going to have the Advent brunch. It's going to be December 3rd after the 10:30 service. If you're able to bring something to share, there's a sign-up sheet, and if you don't know what, if you don't cook or whatever, I have suggestions if you want to bring something. But if you just want to come, that's fine too. Just let me know how many are coming, because I am preparing a small project, so I'd like to know how many to prepare for. Okay.
9:30 service, around 10:30, quarter to 11, something like that. And we always have plenty of food left over, so, you know.
Don't feel you have food.
Yes, so if you, you know, want to come and it's just not your day to make something, just come. We always have plenty of food to share. Altar flowers? You want me to do that because of your
mask?
Yeah,
you can do it.
Okay, in the bulletin here, there's an announcement about the altar flowers. So those who actually sign up for Thanksgiving offerings or memorials for flowers, for many years, the fee has been $45. And with the cost of flowers increasing, the decision has been made and it was approved to increase the cost of flowers donation to $60. And that will start in January.
I might add too, if it's too much, maybe you can go together with somebody.
Sure.
I can always do two arrangements. Cool. You don't always have to feel that you can't afford to put it up, to find somebody who wants to share that thing with you.
And that said, on the altar flower memorial list, the sanctuary candle, which burns all the time, it represents the fact that there is consecrated bread and wine in the sacrament house, and the shrine candles for St. James and St. Matthias. There's a lot of open spaces on the memorial list that are posted in the narthex, so you might consider doing something for a loved one or whatever your reasons.
TV? That's a lower cost.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sorry. Yeah. That cost is $15.
Oh.
Yeah. Yes. Message?
So the members of the vestry that are here, can we just do a really quick chat in the office after church? A couple things came up this week that we need to talk about.
As I said in my little reflection following the meditation, the vestry is looking for people who are willing to run for vestry. We need 3 vestry members and 2 wardens this year, and 1 unexpired term. So that's a way to start out. Run for the unexpired term.
That's right.
Okay.
It's a very limited service request.
So in the narthex, when you came in, you might have noticed the information for our adopted family ministry that during Advent, we have 2 families this year, 1 from a local school and 1 from a local family in the area. So the lists are out there. So there's a list for each individual person. So there's a girl, there's a boy and a boy. Girl is grade 5, a boy is grade 8, and a boy is grade 11. They're from the school district, and their gift suggestions are listed. I color-coded them just to be a little easier for you. And then the same for a family. It's about an 8-year-old girl and a 16-year-old boy and a mom. So several of the gift suggestions are actual gift cards. So an easy way for you to participate in the program is to fill out an order form for our gift card program. And you can either put on it that when the card comes in, give it to Deacon Denise for the family and what family it's for, or you just get it and then you give it to me or who's ever here overseeing the gift card program. So that helps us too. Because for every gift card that's ordered through the gift card program, we get a little percentage of the value of that card. So individually, it's not that much, but when you add it all together, it does add up and it turns into a fundraiser for the parish. And Dr. Burns will have two orders going in December. One December 3rd in the evening and one on December 10th in the evening. And you know that program is good for your own personal use also for gifts. Anything else?
No, not at this point.
Anything else to share?